guys, it's Kevin, and this is my TV setup tour for 2022. Alright, so let's start off with the biggest item in the setup, the TV. This is the LG C9 65-inch 4K OLED TV, and just look at it. I bought this in 2019, and it's still one of the best purchases I've ever made. This model is discontinued, so I'll leave a link to the newest one, as well as anything else I mentioned in the description box below. If you're looking to buy a new TV, then I would recommend going OLED. The OLED display has an excellent picture quality, as it should for the price. Each pixel on an OLED TV is self-illuminating, unlike a traditional LCD TV that has an LED backlight. And with 8.3 million pixels, the blacks are pitch black and the colors are vibrant. The TV also supports Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos for superb picture and sound quality. So this TV is thin, and I mean thin. It's thinner than most household items. It's even thinner than a smartphone. On the back of the TV, you'll find a wide array of ports, HDMI, USB-A, Ethernet, audio in and out, etc. I also taped a light strip to the back of the TV. The adhesives wore off. It's by Philips Hue, and I can control the lights with the phone or by using voice commands. Sometimes I wonder why I bought this TV. I could have bought a larger TV that's 2 inches thick and less expensive. But as soon as I use it, I realize why. It's those inky blacks, vivid colors, and thin bezels that create this immersive viewing experience that you can't find anywhere else. Moving on to the TV media stand. This is from Living Spaces, and I've had it for over a decade now. I've used this for my old TV, and it's been great. It's made out of wood and has enough space for all of my devices. And the doors are held shut by magnets, so it keeps any dust and dog hair out. Next to the TV stand are MALM drawers from IKEA. I use these for storing things like books, external hard drives, and cables. I also put my speakers on them, which is the original HomePod. The built-in speakers on the TV are okay, but I wanted more than just an excellent picture quality. With a 7 tweeter array, high excursion woofer, and 6 microphone array, the sound quality is amazing. I grouped these as a stereo pair for an even richer sound. Combine that with Dolby Atmos and spatial audio, sounds can be placed virtually anywhere for that immersive listening experience. Next is my Apple TV 4K. This is the latest generation with the new Siri remote. I know smart TVs have just about every streaming service available, but I have this because of the tight integration between hardware, software, and services. I can have movie night via SharePlay with people that rewind every 15 minutes or talk during important scenes. Or I can play an Apple Arcade game and continue right where I left off on my iPhone or iPad. I can even extend or mirror my Max display without any latency. I can even connect AirPods Max or AirPods Pro to watch videos at full volume without disturbing others. And with spatial audio and dynamic head tracking, I can have a theater-like experience right in my living room. But one of the main reasons I bought this is because of eARC, which stands for Enhanced Audio Return Channel. This allows audio to travel from the eARC port to the Apple TV and then to the stereo HomePod. I can game from any console and have audio play from the HomePod wirelessly without any noticeable latency. And that brings us to the PS5. I've had this for over a year now, and it's one of my favorite consoles. Games can launch within 15 seconds with the new lightning fast SSD. The adaptive triggers and haptic feedback on the new DualSense controller makes you feel like you're in the game. In Astro's Playroom, you can feel the wind blowing. The subtle vibrations as you're sliding down. The splash when Astro dives into the water. Sand literally feels like sand. You can even feel Astro having trouble walking with the sand blowing. The adaptive triggers have an adjustable tension that allows the triggers to be harder or easier to press. You can feel the resistance when you try to accelerate in a jetpack. The PS5 even supports games at 8K or 4K 120fps. But there are limitations. Sony currently caps the PS5 at 4K, and most games support up to 2160p at 30fps with ray tracing, or 1620p at 60fps. I did run into some issues regarding storage because the PS5 only has 667GB available. But after a software update enabling expandable storage, I was able to install a 1TB M.2 SSD. And before anyone says anything, the PS5 hasn't overheated. I bought this USB fan that's plugged directly to the back of the PS5, and it sucks all of the hot air out of the TV stand. I also leave the door open for more airflow. You may have noticed the PS5 is black and not white. I installed dark plates from Dbrand before Sony released the official ones, and an MKBHD icon skin to hide that glossy center. On the other side of the PS5 is the Nintendo Switch OLED and iPhone boxes. I was debating on whether or not I should get one because the upgrades were minimal. But after using it for hours, I made the right decision. 90% of my game time is in handheld mode, so I took advantage of the new OLED display. Even though it's still 720p, the colors are vivid and the blacks are pitch black. The other 10% is played while docked, either with family or friends, or if I just want to play on a bigger screen. The Switch is also still 1080p when docked, not 4K. It's not bad though. The LG OLED TV does a good job of upscaling, plus I get to enjoy sound through the stereo HomePod. On the bottom of the TV stand, sorry about the dust, are my controllers. NES, Pro Controller, Joy-Cons, and DualSense controllers. I also have my PS4 and PS5 games. No Switch games because I buy them digitally. As for my couch, I won't show it because I have packages and boxes on it. But I do sit fairly close to the TV, about 7 feet, for optimal viewing. And that's it for my TV setup. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!